Over 3 years after its first flight and first delivery target, the Boeing 777X still finds itself in the certification process. Boeing's latest widebody has been hit with delays due to COVID, but it hasn't stopped there. Engine troubles and extra regulator scrutiny have also been factors in pushing back the first delivery by roughly 5 years. However, the planemaker has been busy in recent months, restarting tests and even booking new customers. Here's the latest on the 777X in 2023. Boeing's four testbed 777Xs, all eventually going to customers, have been hard at work. Each plane has been designated a specific role. One is focused on low-speed aerodynamics, while another on flight loads and another on auto-landing. After a brief pause at the end of last year due to an issue with the GE9X power plants, the planes have been busy flying since December 2022. November 779 X-ray Whiskey has been the busiest, with electronic, taxi tests and more. Meanwhile, November 779 X-ray Zulu has been on the ground since November 2021. The jet is focused on extended twin operations, reliability and more. Currently, the plane maker expects the first 777X to be delivered in early 2025. The timeline has been slipping for a few years now, with the last target of Q4 2024 being delayed. The next crucial step, Type Inspection Authorization, or TIA, is expected to be nearing. This will see FAA pilots hop on board to authorize final certification steps. As noted by Mentor Pilot, Boeing has been forced to move around resources over the past year. At first, the plane maker was concerned that it wouldn't receive a cockpit change waiver for the 737 MAX 7 and MAX 10. This forced it to deploy engineering and testing resources to those jets. However, with Congress authorizing a waiver, the focus has since returned to the 777X, allowing it to inch closer to its type inspection authorization. On the topic of the Boeing 777X's severe delays and its latest 2025 entry into service target, the company's chief executive officer, Dave Calhoun, was reportedly denied his $7 million bonus due to delays. The company encouraged the performance-based incentive when he replaced CEO Dennis Muhlenberg in 2020. The motivation was based on reaching at least 7 milestones by the end of 2023. The Boeing Compensation Committee met in August 2022 and noted that the incentive would not be granted because the Boeing 777X was unlikely to enter service by 2023, which was the manufacturer's goal. The CEO will not be left entirely out of pocket for incentive payments. Indeed, Calhoun is on track to receive most of his performance-based goals, including reintroducing the Boeing 737 MAX into service. The committee also respected Calhoun's development timeline for the Boeing 777X, which has advanced in respect to the manufacturer's best interest. This has come at the cost of the CEO's bonus. In late June 2023, it was noted that Boeing and engine maker General Electric, or GE, had jointly agreed to allow Emirates to conduct an integral part of the 777X program's advancement. Liham News and Analysis first reported the development at a Boeing event related to the Paris Air Show. The outlet confirmed that the 777-9 variant is set to go to Dubai in 2024 for about 2 months of proving flights. It's fitting that Emirates will be one of the airlines involved in the certification process for the airliner. After all, the airline is Boeing's largest customer for the new wide-body jet. Indeed, Emirates has more than 100 airframes on order. 2024's proving tests will mark nearly 5 years since the airline initially expected delivery of the plane, which has evidently experienced several delays. On the topic of Emirates orders for the 777X, we reported in late July that Emirates seems to be sticking to its previous threat about gradually abandoning the Boeing 777-8 after Boeing paused the program. A quick analysis of Boeing's June order book shockingly revealed that the Gulf carrier substituted 16 777-8s for the 777-9 instead. This comes a decade after the initial order was placed at the Dubai Air Show in 2013. The airline's president, Tim Clark, has routinely expressed frustration with Boeing's supposed lack of communication and its overall quote-unquote incompetence concerning the 777X program. With the 777-8 paused and the 777-9 expected to be delivered in 2025, Clark also chose to downsize his airline's Boeing 777X order a few times. Excluding this supposed variant swap, the count would set at 115 aircraft, including 35 777-8s and 80 777-9s. The airline has also ordered Airbus A350s and Boeing 787s as a likely backup. At the time of this video's production, neither Boeing nor Emirates have responded with comment or confirmation of an order adjustment. If we suppose that it's true, then the Emirates order would have shifted to 19 777-8s and 96 777-9s. In hindsight, the reduced range of the 777-9 is unlikely to deter Emirates, given its expected quicker timeline than the frozen 777-8 passenger variant. While Boeing has been taking direct criticism from customers like Emirates and indirect pessimism with delayed delivery timelines from others, the company booked a significant new 777X order this year. In February, Air India booked 10 777-9s. This made the Indian flag carrier the eighth customer for the latest generation widebody. The order was part of a 470-jet order by the carrier to both Airbus and Boeing. While 10 is not the biggest order by any margin, it is an important vote of confidence in a highly delayed program. Indeed, the market is primed for a new widebody to take the place of the 747 and replace the aging 777 Classic variants. The project also took another step forward last year when Boeing unveiled the 777X Freighter. This has garnered interest from the likes of Qatar Airways, Cargo Lux, Ethiopian Airlines, and more. At the end of May 2023, Reuters reported that Cathay Pacific is poised to announce a modest order for six new Boeing 777-8 freighters. The order, estimated at around $2 billion, will be earmarked to partially renew the airline's aging 747 freighter fleet. At the time of making this video, however, these rumors have yet to materialize. Indeed, the airline neither confirmed nor denied their intentions when speaking with media, saying, "We continue to invest in and grow our fleet with the addition of new, state-of-the-art and fuel-efficient aircraft. We have no specific updates or announcements to make at this time regarding the fleet." While the 777X freighter was a response to the Airbus A350F, it will be a while before we see the 777XF take to the skies, since Boeing's priority is getting the passenger 777-9 into service. The 777X freighter, on the other hand, is set to be built on the frame of the 777-8. For now, the 777X project has its work cut out for itself, with airlines eagerly waiting for their new jets to arrive. What do you think of the state of the 777X program at the moment? And what do you think of the CEO losing his multi-million dollar bonus due to delays? Could it be a positive sign that the company chief is unwilling to cut corners and rush progress for his personal profit? Share your thoughts by leaving a comment. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.